Hello again, Charles Anderson, doing another Aspen training, Aspen Custom Modeler training video. Several of you have been kind enough to watch my channel, leave comments and likes, so thank you very much for that. One of the things that's been happening is a couple of people have asked me to have a look and troubleshoot or deal with specific problems. One of those people, Ahmad in Australia, was kind enough to let me use his file to demonstrate how I go about the troubleshooting, so I thought that might make an interesting topic for the video, for a quick video. So let's do that. Let's open the file up, see what's happening. The first thing that we notice is there's a bunch of warning messages here in the simulation messages window. So that's an interesting place to start looking. Let's have a look at the flow sheet. I've got B1, which is flash time. That's probably a custom model. Yep. And then the streams that are connected to it are material streams, which are coming from the Aspen library. So let's have a look at the model itself. And you can see it's a flash model where I've got temperature, pressure, energy going in, some function calls. And here's where my ports are being defined. So I'm using mole fraction ports. Then let's have a look at the Aspen model that we're using. So that's in streams, and we're using a material stream. And you can see the material stream is using an AP port. So with different ports on different models, there's a strong possibility that my variable types aren't going to match, or that I'm not passing all the information that I need to pass from one thing into the other. So to address those warnings, what I would recommend, and what I'd recommend probably anyway, is to try and make sure that you're using the appropriate sort of port, that your ports match. Okay, so the two options then are I rewrite the flash time model to use AP ports, or I rewrite or the material stream to use mole fraction ports. Let's have a quick look at the way Aspen has written their model. And this is really a stream that can do anything. I've got one, two phase, three phase flash. I've got polymer stuff going on. I've got solids. I'm handling reverse flow. There's lots and lots and lots of different ways in which this model can work and be configured. And frankly, it's more code than I'm willing to read through. And it seems like a lot of overkill for what we're trying to do here. So instead, what I'd recommend doing is we start off by writing our own stream. And I think I covered a lot of this in an earlier model, an earlier video, so I'll run through it really quickly. But what I've done is I've created two ports that match the ones in Ahmad's model. I've said that the outlet conditions, the outlet variables on the port, match the inlet variables of the port, so the stream really isn't doing anything. The one thing that it does that's kind of cute is that if my feed is not connected, then it's going to make sure that the model is square. So I'm going to define my flow, temperature, pressure, and composition. It's then going to, depending on whether it's liquid or vapor, calculate the enthalpy and the density. And then finally, it's going to convert the density into a specific volume, which is needed to define that inlet variable. If, on the other hand, the inlet stream is connected, then this equation will work the other way around, and it'll define the density based on that specific volume. So nice, simple little stream. But what that lets me do then is connect up to this model. What I'll do is I'll just clear that out, and then I'll get rid of these streams. And you can see as I do that, it's telling me S1 and S2 are still not good. So let's get rid of S2. It'll tell me S1's no good, so let's get rid of S1. And so now I've got a model with no error messages, but I'm underspecified by 8, which is those variables coming in. So let's grab one of these new streams that I've created, connect that up to the model, call it S1 again. And you can see that the model is square. I could connect the discharge ports, but for now, I'm not going to worry about it. So that's good. The question is, does the model work like this? So let's run because it's square. And what it says is, no, you're getting singular decomposition. So I get the red X and singular decomposition. So what that means is that there's one section of the model where I've got too many equations or too many variables fixed, and another part of the equation where I don't have enough variables or equations fixed. So overall, I've got the right number of variables and equations, but in localized areas, I have an imbalance. It's kind of a nasty problem to try and track down. And so what I would usually do in that scenario is try and break my model up and make sure that I understand how each individual section of the model works. So to do that, what I would typically do is I would start with a blank piece of paper. I would take a copy of the original model, and then I would paste it to create another copy. I've done that already to save time and save you watching me type. And so that's what I've got here. So let's compare these two models. I've reordered it slightly, and mostly what I've done is I've taken most of the variables and I've commented them out, and then I started adding back equations one at a time to make sure that I understood what was going on. So as I did that, I think the first thing is this section of code in the original model where Allard's creating local variables for flow, temperature, pressure, enthalpy, and so on. As I look at this, I see that there's two equations. There appear to be two equations defining the feed density, and that gives me pause. So what I've done is I've commented one of those out, and then I also notice that there's a function call that's defining the inlet enthalpy as a function of temperature and pressure. Well, that's already been done by the upstream model or the upstream stream, so that seems redundant. So I've taken those two equations out. And then I also see that there's these definitions of rho F liquid and rho F vapor. I didn't see those being used anywhere, so I've commented those out for now as well, just to try and keep the model as simple as possible. So what I've got now is a relatively simple model where I've got I've got my feed stream coming in. So I'm using my new feed coming into this new Flash 2 model. And I can now have a look and see if it runs. And fortunately, it does. It's solved. It's given me all the answers that I want. And so that's at least a good start. So now what I've got is I've got a basis converging model where I can get where I want. And now I can start adding complexity to it. So what I would do next is start uncommenting some of the other variables. I've done that in Flash 3. So what you'll see now in Flash 3 is I've added a flow of liquid. I've got a vapor fraction. This is defining my vapor and liquid flow. I've got my function calls that I've put back in based on the outlet temperature and pressure to give me my vapor pressure and eccentricity factor, or activity coefficient rather, so that I can do my flash calculation. What I noticed in the original model, if you remember, I've commented two equations out of this model and haven't put them back in yet around the feed, which makes me think that was where I had too many variables or equations defined. And so this flash is where I'm missing some. If I read through the code, I didn't see anywhere where I was doing a component balance. So what I've done is I've added a component balance where I'm saying the flow of the component in is equal to the flow of the component out in the liquid plus the flow out in the vapor. I'm using matrix calculation here. You'll see that X, Y, and Z are defined as arrays on component list, but because they have the same array set, I don't have to explicitly get every single variable. I can just write it as a single equation. And that's great, but if I keep track of the variables that I'm fixing, you can see what I've done is I've used the equation name to help me understand which variable I think I'm fixing. So I've created with this equation, I've F in is something I've already created up above. So I've got liquid out and vapor out. So this one I'm going to assign to the liquid out. This one I've added a new variable, vapor fraction. So VF. So I've used that as a comment. So I've got now three new variables, two equations. So I'm still one degree of freedom short. This one is the vapor pressure. This one is giving me the gammas. So that's another 2n, but that's 2n new equations. Sorry. I've also created T in and P, sorry, P out and T out. So I've got and X. So I've got 2 plus n, actually 2 plus 3n new variables, and only 2n new equations. So trying to close up my difference between the number of variables and the number of equations. Here, I'm introducing n new equations, but no new variables. That's good. That brings me down a little bit. Here, I've got another n variables with no new equations. Sorry, another n equations with no new variables. So I've brought myself down from... Actually, that's not true. This has got y in, so I added a new... Anyway, you can see what I'm doing. I'm trying to keep track of the number of variables and the number of equations I've got, and assigning nominally in my head variables to equations so that I keep the whole thing square. You can see here I'm still short of equations with this equation set. So I throw in an enthalpy balance that adds two new variables, but then I have three equations that I can have. I then choose just to, because I know that I want my compositions to add to one, add another equation here. So that actually makes me square in terms of the calculations. And it looks like I, for some reason, didn't take these equations out as well. But what I would normally have done is left these equations commented out. Just to see, to make sure that it makes sense. If I leave these equations commented out, compile flash 3, you can see that it does, it leaves me square, it leaves me well defined, so that's good. And then the next thing I would do is, okay, so let's define the outlet ports. For that, I need to move these variables over into the port variables and calculate the densities. So if I do that, you can see I'm still square. So what I do is I sort of work through the model, trying to add as few new variables as I can, and try and get the thing to match. So the model is square. Does it converge? Yes, it does. It works nicely. But you'll see I'm not quite done yet. I've made a version 4. Ahmed, when I sent this back to him, said, yeah, that's great, but it only converges in the liquid phase. Why is that? And he actually came up with a very elegant way of solving that. So what you'll remember is in this version 3, just to get the equation square, I threw in the sum of x is 1. And that's fine as long as the model is in the liquid phase or in the two-phase region. That's a reasonable thing to say. But if I happen to move the model up into the super heated region, then x no longer equals 1. And the sum of x no longer equals 1, and so I need to come up with a different way of formulating this. The way Ahmed solved that, which is quite cute, I think, is he created this new variable hmix. So he's calculating the enthalpy of the mixture at the specified outlet temperature and pressure, and then creates a dummy variable which is allowed to float, and then puts in an if statement that says, if the dummy variable is less than or equal to 1, then the sum of x is 1, like I had over here. But if it's equal to 1, then the sum of y equals 1. And then you define your vapor fractions. And so this is an alternative way of formulating it that now allows me to move that model into the two-phase region successfully. And so I'm not going to go through all the demonstration, but Ahmed has run this model under various conditions and nicely shown that it works. Finally, me showing off a little bit, you'll see that what we've done to this point is we've left the all variables table to show what equations we've got. What I did was I created this flash 5, which is just a copy of flash 4, but I added a form which let me create this summary table, which lets me then grab some of these variables, order them in the way I like, and set them up. So now when I double click on Flash 5, I get a sort of sorted table with the way that I liked it logically set out to see what's going on. The other thing I did was I created an icon. That's a bit difficult in version 11, but in version 10, and I'm told in version 12, that's a relatively simple thing to do. But then you can choose where you put your ports. You can make it look kind of pretty like this. And then the final thing that I did was, and anybody who's seen me code before knows that I'm a bit of a layout geek. I tried to structure the model a little bit so that I can see what's going on. A little bit better. So I've put in some spacings and comments and stuff like that. It really doesn't change the functionality of the model any, but it makes it easier for me to read. The other thing that I've done is rather than have these local copies of variables, so for example, flowmin equals feed.f, what I've done is I've just eliminated that altogether. There's less variables, there's less code to try and read through that way, and I find it slightly easier to follow. So you can see I've condensed out some of the variables that weren't being used and got rid of some of the bits and pieces that were floating around. Okay, that's what I wanted to show. Thank you very much for your time, and I will look forward to talking to you another one. Bye-bye.